Zip zippity doo! Welcome to episode 5 of Runs with Mr. Run. Once again, I am Dr. Doo.
And I am his host, Gexup. And with us in this episode, we have Hanu, the Hun Nakedu.
Hi there.
All right. Yes. Well, how you doing up there, Sendu and Hanu?
How are you up there? Fine. I don't know how I got up here.
I'm doing fine. It's just my least energetic intro ever. Sorry about that.
Don't worry. We're not in the booch out mood. We're all in the pissed off mood because of this new topic that we're going to be discussing about. So, Sendu, what are we going to be discussing about in this episode of Rants on the Run?
How to save the rainforest. Or 3D movies.
No. 3D movies, they don't need saving. They need to crawl under a rock and fucking die.
Okay. So that's our topic. Why 3D movies need to crawl under a rock and die. Hunter the Hun Mechanin has given us this the suggestion of making this topic because, you know, he wants something else besides another list from IGN, which we're now stop doing. But anyway, so he made a blog, his own list and his own writing website called The 10 Reasons Why 3D Needs to Crawl Under the Rock and Die. And, you know, he made 10 lists, but I can make 20. Because I got a lot more to say than all the things that he written down. Not to make you feel bad or anything.
No. It's just a pick of the best reasons that I can think of. But yeah, it's worth just noting just how completely redundant this entire concept of this technology really is.
Okay, so let's discuss talking about 3D movies. Let's first hear about what Hanu has to say about 3D movies in general. Or the 3D technology in movie theaters.
Generally speaking, I just do not see any purpose behind 3D as a cinematic device. Because, okay, so it creates the illusion of depth, but I don't see why that is such a big part. It's an entirely visual thing. It doesn't add depth to the story. It doesn't make the actors better. Or, you know, it doesn't do anything except create this pop-up effect that some people may find disorienting. I myself don't really care for at all. It's just a gimmick. And what's even more ridiculous about it, that it's a sort of a trend that just keeps resurfacing over and over as time has gone on. I am just getting sick of the fact that it's becoming the sort of main selling point of movies now. Don't you agree?
Honestly, you know, I'm thinking back to when I was a little kid, you'd go to an amusement park and see these specific theaters built around 3D. Those were cool. They actually came way out in your face. But this new stuff, it's just, I don't even notice it half the time.
All right, now here's my opinion about 3D movies. 3D is a waste of a perfectly good dimension. Quote by Roger Ebert. But here's my biggest gripe about 3D technology. It's frustrating to be watching this stupid new gimmick that they're trying to make their movies a lot more interesting than they already are. Oh my goodness, let's see now. The frustration right now is that you have to wear the glasses, and it's,
yeah,
you know,
the yeah, first, if I can jump, because the yeah, first if I, time... If I can jump in just for a minute, that's exactly what the problem is, like, that you have to. Right now, the choice has really been taken out of the hand of the moviegoer. Like, a few years back, just before Avatar, there were 3D movies, but they were kind of in the margin. Then Avatar came, and now it's the rule. Now almost every movie needs to be in 3D for some reason. Yeah.
Well, every big blockbuster action flick that has to be in 3D, yeah. Like Pirates of the Caribbean, Strangers.
But there used to be a lot more of that. That you had the choice of just, you know, if you didn't care for 3D, you didn't have to go. But now all the big movies are in 3D, so it's kind of something like you can't even ignore it anymore.
Well, I would disagree that all the movies are in 3D because, you know, I still go to movies that are not 3D, but I, you know, that's not part of the topic. But anyway, I just hate the fact that this technology is not even, you know, this idea of putting movies in 3D is not getting any better. I mean, like, it's still aggravating us to watching, you know, wearing those glasses that were red and blue.
Yeah.
And red and blue was, like, the worst color you can ever try to watch in 3D. And now they come up with this shady glasses that's really hard to see. I mean, like, it's like wearing sunglasses, for crying out loud. And wearing shades in a movie theater, and especially when the movie is showing movies that have like a lot of shadowy and dark effects. That makes it even worse to watch it.
Yeah, that's definitely been the big problem of like, and you know, some people have actually like tried to deal with that. They say that lighting in 3D movies needs to be better, but in my view, it's just, why are you creating the problem? Don't make the movie in 3D. That's basically the answer.
Oh, yeah. And, you know, another thing about 3D is just that, you know, people get motion sickness. And I mean, like, you know, right now, the Nintendo 3DS has came up with this new technology where you don't have to wear any glasses to make the 3D. But at the same time, trying to play games on 3D without the glasses, you have to center your eyes to the center, and it's yeah, also as frustrating to play the 3DS. So, you know, when I play the 3DS, I don't turn on the 3D. I just turn off the 3D.
Yeah.
At least you have the option.
I mean, I think that's the first step that I really think 3D movies should make, just to be a little less annoying, is just somehow get rid of the glasses. The problem, of course, is that a movie, well, the 3D technology where you don't need glasses, it's because the technology that creates that illusion of depth is actually in the screen. But you can't have that in a movie theater because it's a projection from the back of the theater. That's a thing like, are they ever going to come up with a way to sort of, I don't know, a 3D layered projection of the movie? I don't think it's just light doesn't just work, just doesn't work that way. But I'm not a physics expert.
While we're bashing on 3D, I just want to know, what do you exactly see in 3D? Because, you know, when people describe about 3D, it's like, oh, it's popping out of the screen. Is it really popping out of the screen when you wear the glasses and put on the 3D effects?
It's supposed to be like dimension. Like, you see things behind other things rather than everything being flat. That's their idea.
Yeah, but that's the thing. It's just a gimmick. It's really like, it's for that extra wow factor, which is just, you know... It's there to impress the easily impressed, in my view.
Yeah, especially those people who love to watch the Transformers movie. But anyway.
Say, let me just say on the Transformers movies is that, okay, not, I don't care for the sequels as much. I didn't even go see the last movie. But the first movie I did go see in the theater, and I will have to say that I was impressed, but I didn't go to see it in 3D. I went to see it in just regular old 2D, and I thought that those special effects were good like that. I can't see why you would need the depth, that the supposed depth that 3D adds to it, honestly.
You know, whenever I watch 3D, you know, I kind of chuckle when people say that's an extra dimension, because what I'm seeing is just like moving objects getting closer than, you know, in the background a lot further.
Yeah, that's the whole...
And everything still looks flat.
Yes, and in 3D movies where they don't really emphasize the 3D element, it's like a tree in the foreground that pops up, but you only would notice it if you would kind of move your head a little bit. And, you know, I don't see like myself moving my head for no reason in a movie theater.
I mean, like, the 3D gimmick, let's be honest here. Hollywood is coming up, is running out of ideas of making good storylines nowadays, and they need better, you know, better writers that have like all these wonderful ideas that hasn't been up there in cinema, because, you know, it's kind of aggravating to see that now that we're you know, that we're coming up with more and more action flicks, now they're trying to make it more appealing by putting it into 3D.
Dude, two words: Piranha 3D. Like, what the fuck? Like, what the fuck? A remake of a shitty late 70s horror movie in 3D that's only notable because James Cameron directed the sequel that nobody ever saw. Like, that's, like, that is mind-bogglingly stupid.
Oh, yeah. Man, I don't know what's up with 3D. It just keeps coming. It dies and then it keeps coming back. Yep. I mean, how long have we been using the 3D technology? Since the 1930s.
Yeah, and that's even like the, and it's even more bizarre, like how people have now sort of become very devoted to that technology. James Cameron, obviously, but even before then, like it's been around. It just even makes the filmmakers stupid for some reason. Like the guy who directed the original Creature from the Black Lagoon, you know, he was like severely farsighted or nearsighted, so he couldn't even go watch his own movie because it was originally released in 3D. And the only reason he didn't feel bitter about it, he said, well, Beethoven was deaf. Like, I think that's the most misplaced comparison of two people. Like, okay, you might have been a pretty cool guy for inventing the creature from the Black Lagoon, but a Beethoven you are not.
Man, another aggravating thing about 3D technology is just that, you know, the suspense of disbelief is not there. I mean, like, you know, it's great that you want movies to be more and more thrilling, but at the same time, you want them to be smart and make sense instead of, like, you know, just throwing in, destroy all logic and create more plot holes, which I'm seeing in a lot more movies nowadays.
Yeah, I don't know if that's necessarily true, but I do see that the quality of screenwriting has really just gone down the toilet in the last couple of years. I mean, so many movies nowadays that just don't really have even, like really even tolerable dialogue anymore. It's gotten so... I think we've hit a new time low when Quentin Tarantino is the best writer of movie dialogue out there.
Yeah. Okay, whatever.
Yeah.
I can disagree with that, okay. But anyway. My goodness. And I also despise the fact that 3D... It's coming. It's trying to make remakes of classical movies, and they're all saying that this time it's coming up with releasing this movie.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
What makes your home experience quite different is if you watch it in theaters with the 3D glasses, which has never been done before.
Yeah, and that's just completely stupid. Like, that's my biggest right now. That's the biggest thing that pisses me off about 3D movies is the completely unnecessary re-releasing of older movies that were not even made. Like, newer movies that used 3D but weren't really built for 3D. Like I said, it's usually the tree in the foreground that moves just a little bit. But then when they take an older movie, and I don't know how they do it, is that they basically just isolate, like, elements of the picture, and they move, like, the background a little further away, and then they put the actor slightly forward and, like, make this pop-up book effect. Why does the movie need that, is my big question.
Are you saying that these unnecessary re-releases occurred because of 3D? Because I think they've been going on a lot longer than that.
Well, I don't know, because a re-release can be justified if let's say there's an anniversary of a particular movie. But Titanic? Really? 12 years? What the fuck? A 12th year anniversary? No, I'm not buying that, honestly.
Oh, man. And everybody in the goddamn green earth has already seen Titanic, so do you really need to put it in 3D?
I think James Cameron is just doing that just for the fuck of it. I mean, just for the hell of it. There's no reason for it, honestly. And I don't know why George Lucas is re-releasing the Star Wars movies all over again just because to have the 3D effect in there. Maybe for the prequel movies, but... I don't see why we would need it in the I don't see why we would need it for the older movies.
He's doing it chronologically from episode 1 all the way through 6.
Well, exactly, but I don't know. I'm a little happier that they're at least putting the movies in the chronological order, but still it doesn't make any sense to me.
But Anu, I know you're going to get really pissed off when I tell you this, but my goodness. You know how, like, everybody's so pissed off with all the edits that George Lucas has made on the prequel films? He made so many edits on episode 1. I remember that you put in your top 10 reasons why episode 1 was awesome, and you said Yoda is a puppet. They took away the puppet. They made him into full CG.
Yeah, that's completely unnecessary, yeah.
Big time. Oh, my goodness. I mean, like... I know I'm in a ranting topic, and I said this a lot of times. I'm pretty much one of those people that keep saying it again and again, why George Lucas is doing all these, you know, unnecessary edits. But, man, how much more edits do you really need, George Lucas? Just let the film let it be and just, you know, let us keep rebuying these films instead of just, like, you know, making a big gigantic change. Because I absolutely hated that edit when George Lucas made in episode 6, when you know, the part where the Emperor dies. Why did Darth Vader have to scream out, "No, no, no"? I mean, that was like the perfect.
I haven't seen that, but wow, that sounds bad.
Oh, it was terrible. Just when you thought that George, you know, just when you thought that Harrison Ford moving his head for being the second one to shoot before.
So, oh my God. The digital head bob.
Yes.
Oh man. DHB digital head bob.
But back in back in 3D, the aggravating thing about 3D is that there's so many movies that was not built for 3D.
Yeah, like that's the big thing. Like it's being used in movies that really don't need it at all.
Well, I'm not saying like action flicks. I'm talking about films that has nothing spectacular with its visuals.
Yeah, that's what I'm getting at too. Is that, you know, I'm pretty sure like a few years down the line some drama movie directors are so desperate to get people in that they just gonna put out a 3D release just for the hell of it.
And but you won't believe it. You won't believe it. They are doing it now.
Oh really?
Yeah. Let me see. One of the films, The Void. Oh God. Do we really need to see The Void in 3D? No. Yeah. The Vow. That's right. Fuck Vow.
Oh yeah.
Oh man. Let me see. Oh, and also comedy films are getting into 3D.
Yeah.
Oh man. Oh boy. Man, how much longer are we going to use this 3D technology? I mean, like, we just need to figure out a way to make our films a lot more appealing artistic wise, not just like, you know, brain dead wise that we get from.
Yeah, because we're still lacking in this current era of 3D. We're lacking that one movie that really shows how stupid 3D is. Like the 1980s, they had one, Jaws 3D. When that came out, people saw, like, what the fuck are we doing? Let's stop this foolishness.
What about Harold and Kumar 3, where they purposely made fun of it, even though it was in 3D?
Yeah. I got one question. Do you sometimes roll your eyes when you watch the trailer and it says, come watch this movie in IMAX theaters?
Well, we don't have IMAX theaters, so no.
Well, anything that's 3D like that.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, I found an article that James Cameron said the 3D craze is stupid. You want to see that article?
Whoa. Has James Cameron turned his boat around? Or is this an older one?
I don't know. I think this is like around when years after James Cameron released Avatar. Let me see. Oh, it was in 2010. That was a year after Avatar. Oh,
so,
wow.
So, yes. Wow. Well, that's unusual because...
That's the odd. 3D made his movie big time.
Well, I'm happy that he has some common sense left, so.
Yeah.
But man, that's a heavy thing to say, you know, considering like that's the reason Avatar was as big as it is.
Oh, are you sure? Are you sure it wasn't the compelling story and interesting plot twist?
No, Avatar is the biggest example of just an overhyped film that has so much substance with the visuals, but absolutely no substance with the story.
That movie actually came free with my phone, and I couldn't get through the first 30 minutes of it. It was so boring.
Exactly. I mean, like, I just, you know, Avatar, you know, that's the best example of a film that's completely lackluster. I just roll my eyes every time when people say, that's the best movie I've ever seen in my life. I'm like, oh, right.
Oh, people stopped saying that when the Avengers came out.
You know what? Yeah, the thing about Avatar is that like I can't be too pissed off about it because if that movie had failed, because it was a hellishly expensive movie that Cameron, like he spent almost a decade making that film, mm-hmm. and if it had failed, it would have pretty much meant the end of his movie career. But that's the weird thing about James Cameron, like he's. He takes on like these massive, massive movie projects, like Titanic, for instance. Like that was the most expensive movie made up to that point. So, wow. So and yet somehow he like makes it out on top. Like I don't know. He just manages to somehow just slip by with millions of dollars in his pocket. I don't know.
well, I really like his one of his interviews saying that, you know, the more and more we pay, for the advertising and all the budgeting for the movie, you know, That's how much lower his, you know, the amount of money he gets. But when the movie releases, that's how much higher it goes. So you know, what he was doing was a big risk. So he took two big risks of making Titanic and... No. First Terminator 2, then Titanic, then Avatar.
Yeah, because so many movies that have had like the similar kind of budget in the, you know, in the history of movies have really never, you know, they've gone in a bad way most of the time. So it's kind of amazing that Cameron hasn't fucked up yet.
Yeah, big time. You know, I would like to see that, you know, Avatar 2, he never listened to any of his critics' criticism about the storyline, and he made another 3D film. Oh, you know, that's kind of funny. You know, if he's going to make Avatar 2, and he's already saying that the 3D craze is stupid, that'll be completely hypocritical when he makes another Avatar film and then makes it to 3D.
It's kind of weird. Like, I've become I have very conflicted feelings about James Cameron because he's done some of my favorite movies.
Yeah, me too.
And yet he's directly to blame for this current craze of 3D, the fact that it's gotten as big as it has.
I mean, like, if you want to try 3D, try to go to an illusion gallery, painting gallery, because those are fun. Because all you have to do is stand in front of the painting and take a picture, so it can look like it's you know, the painting is actually coming out of real life. But movies, it's not fun. It hurts your eyes big time.
Yeah,
not to mention there's a lot of people that have motion sickness, and that's not making the movie experience any better.
Yeah, that's the biggest hiccup that's another big hiccup with this technology, is that it just is not for everybody, and I hope that this is going to be the thing that eventually kills it, because, you know, I don't get motion sickness, but I do get headaches occasionally when I go to see a 3D movie, but it really depends on how extreme of a 3D movie it is. Like, if it's got a million things flying around, you know, then it might do that to me. If it's like the one or two trees in the foreground that's moving a little bit, then probably not. But you know, it's also just a pain in the ass to just see, like, if your 3D glasses are working, and if they're not, you gotta leave the theater and go get a working pair.
Oh, and, yeah, and not to mention some of those glasses run on batteries, right?
And whose head structure are they designed for? Seriously.
Yeah, that's the thing, is that they're supposed to be like a sort of universal size, but it's like you can't fold them away or anything. They're kind of a pain in the ass, and also, like, people who seriously, like, are either have like really bad eyesight, or let's say if they've had a car accident and they're missing an eye, those people are not getting anything out of the movie going experience, because you cannot perceive 3D with only one eye.
Yeah, you need, like, good depth perception. It's kind of like, you know, how, like,
you need depth perception for a start, which you do not have if you are missing one of your eyeballs.
Yeah, so. I love that. I love that running gag in Futurama where Leela always has bad depth perception.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I always love that joke.
It's just the fact that, you know, if the technology is preventing you from enjoying the movie, then something's wrong with the technology. It cannot be the problem of the people going to see the movie, honestly.
Yeah, and I have not yet seen a 3D film that can just blast me off, you know, and believing that this is good technology. Because every time I see a 3D, I can't finish the film. I swear to God. And it's even worse that they're coming up with 3D, you know, they're selling 3D glasses, but now they're coming up with 3D television that's two times expensive than buying a flat screen TV.
Coming up, that's been out for a while.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So I haven't seen one yet.
Oh, I've seen them. I've seen them in stores. They got glasses. It comes with one pair free and more sold separate.
You have to wear glasses to see 3D television?
Some of them, yes, and some of them don't come with more than one pair. You have to buy separate for like $30 each.
Oh my God.
Well, although you can you can reuse the ones they give you at theaters.
Well, that's
it's a trick to make you go to the movies.
Yeah, I think that's a completely retarded idea. Like, why would you want to wear that thing at home? I don't want to even throw. I don't want to wear it at the theater either. But I have to if I want to watch a movie.
I think there are some TVs that don't use them, but you have to stand like perfectly aligned with it, sit perfectly aligned to see it.
That too is completely retarded. I don't see why is the operative question here. There's no point to it. Oh God.
I got one question. You know, as much as we like the bash on 3D, what about 3D movie rides? Do you also think that's bullshit as well?
I don't know, because that would probably be, if it's like clearly for, hey, there's no reason for this, but you're gonna have a hell of a time, kind of a deal. Okay, but you know, movies are capable of so much more. We don't need to be, you know, I'm not two and in my diapers, for God's sake. I'm not impressed by this fucking technology.
Well, in my personal opinion, I just, you know, 3D rides, at least they're like less than you know, like 10 minutes of an experience, like Donald Duck's 3D magical show or something like that, right? And when, you know, but watching 3D for over an hour, my God, I can't take it. You know, it feels like your eyes are just burning at the glimpse of the screen.
How do you feel? Sendu just put up the price for what a 3D TV can cost.
$5,000. That's
buy a car for that kind of money, for God's sake.
Oh my goodness! And you can also buy consoles and over 20 games with that kind of money. Come on, people.
Actually, how do you guys feel about not the 3DS, but like consoles supporting 3D TVs? Games do support 3D. You know,
that's just I don't know. That's just complete bullshit.
I could pick one. You know, Batman Arkham Asylum, and you know, on the PlayStation 3, where they have like the 3D edition or something like that. That's terrible. You know, it just makes me dislike Batman Arkham Asylum more and appreciate Batman Arkham City even much more. It's just that games in 3D, it's already bad enough that we have to sit through over an hour of a movie just to watch it in 3D, but playing games for hours upon hours, games are like not meant for like just like an hour or two of an experience. It requires like over 10 hours or so, or even like a week to finish. And you know, trying to put 3D technology in for a week of gaming entertainment, I swear I'm going to go blind.
What?
No, it's not boy.
I have to disagree there. I kind of tend to play in very sort of short intervals, like an hour maybe at a time.
Oh, okay.
On a single game myself, but I still don't see any point in 3D in games. I got pissed off when games started to be in HD. To begin with, because that too was completely it's just complete and utter vanity is all it is, and it doesn't add anything to the viewing experience. It makes the picture sharper, so fucking what?
Yeah, I mean, like, you know, I always hated, you know, okay, now we're jumping from movies to video games, so while we're in this topic, let's discuss about HD.
I'm not agreeing with you, but I have met gamers who say they play games a lot for graphics.
Oh, I hate those kind of people who just say that needs graphics for entertainment, because that just makes level designs a lot less intuitive.
Like, you know what? I've had the complete opposite reaction. So I started playing Mass Effect 2, and the graphics are so good that I'm actually distracted from the game. Like, what the fuck is going on?
Yeah, but when you cut off the HD, you realize that it's a very linear game. And, you know, it's nothing there but shooting all the time. And watching some cinematics as well.
Yeah.
I thought you liked Mass Effect 2, Gex.
Oh, man, my love for Mass Effect 2 has disappeared after Mass Effect 3. Fuck you, EA. Why do I have to keep bringing up Mass Effect 3? I just suffered from that god-awful game.
It's okay. So, let's go back to movies.
Does anybody have anything else to say about, like, anything else on 3D?
You want
to...
I'm thinking about it. There was something I wanted to say, but God damn it, I blanked out.
Okay, we can wait.
We can go over your list a little more in depth while he does that.
All right, let's go take a look at Hanu the Hun Mackinnon's top 10 reasons why 3D needs to die and crawl under the rock.
Yep. So okay. Go on, Gex.
All right. Reason number one. 3D accomplishes nothing. To be honest, none of the technology innovates in films from the past 20 years and have accomplished anything. Yeah, that is definitely true. I mean, like, oh my goodness. Okay, people who think that, who are defending 3D, I'm telling you right now, watch Jaws in 3D. Good God.
the next one's kind of funny.
Okay, you read it off, Cindy.
Reason number two, 3D glasses make you look like a moron. They got batteries in them. Eventually, I want some with the glasses with a computer in it.
Oh, man. You know, don't you just kind of find it funny when people say that graphics are important because, you know, one of these days we're going to come up with graphics that's much more realistic than reality itself? I read that in an article in a video game magazine.
How is that even possible?
That's holograms. And they're going to bring back
holograms.
Oh, and they're going to bring... they're going to bring back full motion videos where they just stick a chip in someone so you can control them. Die once and the game is now useless.
I got one question since we're on the topic of video games. Do you think we actually hit the wall of making games that'll be a little more realistic graphically?
That would be the first crisis on PC. when that game came out, no computer could run it.
But you know, every like 5 years, sort of processor power and you know all that technical capabilities of computers to just jump dramatically. I just think it's I don't know. I don't know what's accomplished by trying to make games look more realistic, because I find that when a game is more realistic, I always find that it's usually a lot less fun to play, to be honest. Like, I just want a very unreal experience. That's what I'm personally looking for.
How did you get game graphics from 3D glasses look like a moron?
Word association. Gotta love it.
Oh, man, but when you turn around, I have to agree with him when number two, when 3D glasses look like, make you look like a moron. When I turn around and look at everybody in the theater wearing 3D glasses, oh, my goodness, they look like drones. They don't look human.
Yeah. I mean, just look at the picture I put. I was looking for an image of people watching a movie in 3D, I was looking for an image of 3D glasses, and I was thinking of putting that sign over it, which is in the blog, and then I found this old black and white picture of people from their style of dress, I would say from the 50s, in the theater watching a movie in 3D, and you know that's the reaction. It's like everybody's wearing the same glasses. It looks like a parody of life, basically. <That's it.
laughs> They look like the Men in Black.
Yeah.
Okay. Reason number four on Hans' list.
Three.
Okay.
Three.
Reason number three. Sorry. 3D glasses are uncomfortable and awkward. No arguments there.
Yeah, those things just kind of hug against my head and I balance them on my nose. Like, it doesn't fit my ears at all.
Oh, yeah, and not to mention, they sometimes hurt your nose, too, because, you know...
Yeah, I don't have that problem with my ears because I got such a big, fat head. But, you know, on my nose, definitely, it's just... They just weigh a lot. And I'm wondering if I'm just experiencing the same kind of... experience that people that wear glasses have, but then again, I realize that they actually weigh quite a lot, the 3D glasses.
Oh, so yeah, I think... big time. And it's even worse when you're... Okay, I wear glasses, and, you know, to see far distances, okay? Yep. It's worse when you have to wear your glasses and wear the 3D glasses at once.
Exactly.
I mean, yeah, like, yeah. 3D glasses, I mean, it's great that, you know, they're considerate by people who wear glasses because, you know, they don't have a good vision, so they need to wear glasses to watch movies. But it just makes it even worse and more uncomfortable. It feels like I'm wearing a 5-pound mask on my face. God damn these people.
And now, I mean, like, the way they're shaped, too, I feel like I'm wearing joke glasses.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I also get... And also, they're so big sometimes, like, when it's not completely dark in the theater, or like if a light is shining right above me, I can see my own reflection in the 3D glasses looking back at me. That's like what the fuck?
Yeah, big time.
Yeah.
And you know what I also hate? You know, this is what 3D technology needs if they need more 3D. I'm just saying if. That's a big if, okay?
Yeah.
Why don't you just make 3D glasses that have like good prescription for people's particular vision?
Or contacts.
Oh, I'm not gonna wear fucking contacts. Those things fucking aches like it hurts like hell, man.
Yeah, but
we'll have to get like 3D LASIK.
Yeah, but I think the problem there is that there's so many different types of, you know, impaired vision that it would be just an exorbitantly expensive to make specific glasses for every people, unless they somehow make 3D glasses where you can adjust the lenses.
Yeah, why don't they make that technology? Okay.
Wait, why don't they just make 3D lenses that you can put on top of your glasses?
Yeah, we're living in 2012. 2015 is coming, and all that predictions we made on Back to the Future Part 2 feels like it's going to be blown off the water.
We can put a man on the moon, but we can make a farsighted person see a 3D movie without over discomfort. Basically, what it was.
3D movies have a little deal. They have to sell more LASIK.
All right, let's continue off of the list, Andy.
All right, number 4. 3D adds nothing to the viewing experience. Wah, wah, wah.
Yeah, this is basically me. Yeah, this is what I basically was saying, that it's there just to impress.
Yeah.
The easily impressed that have things flying at the screen, basically.
Yeah, we've already gone over that, and I'm so much.
Let me add a little bit more to that. You know what I kind of find baffling about like movies in Blu-ray, because you know people say it's sharper. Okay, it's great that the picture is better, but no matter how brighter or how much darker or anything you add on the screen, you're basically re-experiencing the same story, the same characters, the same
setting. Exactly. Like, that's why I'm not in a big rush to get a Blu-ray player and start buying movies on Blu-ray, because I don't see how this technology is any better from DVD apart from the sharper image. It's a complete waste. Like, until Blu-ray unless they come up with something completely unique that they can do with Blu-ray they can't do with DVD. Oh, no way. I think that's a video format that just needs to die. I mean, there's no purpose to it.
Actually, it can hold like 10 times the data as Blu-ray. I mean, DVD, so you can actually fit these multi-disc games on one disc with a PlayStation 3. So there's that.
Yeah, well, that's the game. Okay. This is what 3D disc needs. Instead of like just like filling up all that room in the disc just to make the picture better, why not just like figure out to put more, you know, put more features in that particular disc? Because there's no point of having like Blu-ray disc sets in a Blu-ray movie.
Yeah. Yep, you can have the bonus features on one disc.
I mean, you can even fit like 5 documentaries with that much room in a Blu-ray disc if you just didn't shove in all that good clear picture.
Yeah, I was about to just say that. Okay, that was a good point about the memory capacity. Like that's probably the only thing right now that Blu-ray discs have over DVD discs. But I still don't see like it as a sort of a death grip maneuver that's going to choke out DVDs. So, I don't know. Maybe, but it's going to take a few years if they're going to completely phase out DVDs, because right now it's kind of the same thing with VHSs. Like, it took a long time before DVD really came around and showed that there was a, you know, an even more efficient way to kind of to sell home video, basically.
Well, the selling point was DVDs last a lot longer, and the PlayStation 2 definitely helped a lot there.
Yeah, but there's not that same kind of an advantage to the DVD, except for the memory capacity, and I don't think you can. Maybe if they come up with something really that really pushes the Blu-ray, because right now it's only PlayStation 3 games, but I don't know.
You mean like?
Okay, we're getting off topic.
Okay, number 5: poor implementation of glasses test.
Yeah, I experienced this at least in the theaters around where I live, because we have one big national chain of theaters, and what they do is that when about 15 minutes before the movie starts, they let people in, and about 15 minutes before the actual movie starts, we get all these advertisements and things, and then about 5 minutes before the movie starts, they show a little test animation that you can check that your 3D glasses are working, and I find that to be really stupid, because I've been sitting there for almost half an hour in the dark waiting for the movie to start, and then all of a sudden I realized, oh fuck, my glasses are broken, so I gotta go change them. So Like, I don't know why can't we have that animation rolling as you walk in, so as you're taking your seat, you can already see then if, you know, the glasses are working. But this is, like, this main, like it says in the blog, that this might not be true for everybody. Like, how is it for you? Where in the I'm getting ready to sit down to watch a movie process do you take the moment or you get the chance to check if your 3D glasses are actually working?
I don't care if they're working. I just wear them so the picture doesn't look all jittery.
I care about if it's working because I paid top dollars for a 3D experience. You know, because, you know, 3D is watching a movie in 3D is, you know, much more expensive than just watching the movie regularly. So, you know, you're basically throwing money for, you know, a picture of a technology that's broken. The only time when they were testing it out, the 3D, was when I watched Spy Kids in 3D. You know, I'm embarrassed to say that.
Are you saying that they don't, that's not a regular thing for you, that they don't show like a little animation or a trailer?
Yeah, they did. In the beginning of the film, they said, the one of the characters from the movie said that this is how 3D works. When we put on the signal, ding, that means put it on. Do you see the 3D motion picture? Look at my hand, whoosh. And we were like, whoa, because that was like the first time I've ever seen 3D in my life. Right now, it's just
Spy Kids 3. That's like the one movie. That's like the one of the original trilogy they constantly show on TV. I don't get why. I thought the first two were better.
Big time. But
yeah, but my point was basically there that around where I come from, they have all that other shit, those advertisements and things that they show before they get to the test.
There's no 3D in those trailers?
No, they're just regular advertisements that they show before every other movie, like whether it's 3D or not. So, but like I said, this one might not be true for everybody, but it's definitely true for anybody living in Finland because that's a national chain that does it.
Oh, now I remember one of my bad experiences with having a poor 3D glasses. I remember when out of nowhere, when I was watching Pirates of the Caribbean on Stranger's Tide, out of nowhere, the 3D didn't work for the first 5 minutes. I was like talking to my brother. I was like, dude, are you getting any 3D? Yeah, perfectly. I said, let's switch glasses. And he's like, oh, dude, your glasses is out of batteries. I'm like, fuck, man. I only get go out of the theater for bathroom breaks. Not this. God damn these people. I mean, like,
yeah.
Here's my advice to every usher who's in the movie theater. Make sure that the batteries in all those fucking glasses are 100% recharge. Okay? God damn. That was just one of the most poorest excuses of getting out of the movie theater ever.
Oh, you talk as if batteries not included is a new thing.
Oh man. And you know what? You know what? When I went got out of the theater and asked for my glasses to get recharged, it took them another 5 minutes to find another 3D glasses that was fully charged because, you know, they were still charging all the previous ones that before that theater. I was like saying to myself, you know, fuck 3D movie. Fuck IMAX. Fuck everybody who thinks that 3D is what we really need.
Why? Why are they that attractive?
No, because I paid top dollars to see an IMAX movie and blow my socks off. But instead, I just have to wait for people to get that, you know, that glasses fixed.
I'd hate to disappoint, but MythBusters has already proven it's impossible to actually be knocked out of your socks.
I saw that episode.
Just okay, just figuratively, not literally. God damn.
Well, we're halfway through the list, Hanu. Okay. Do you remember what you wanted to talk about?
No, I'm miles away. But let's just move on with the list.
Okay. All right. Sid, it's your turn.
Number six, no alternative 2D showings to some 3D movies. I wonder what 1D is.
Well, except that, you know, with the biggest exception of the changes that Star Wars Episode One has made, what can you say about, like, just alternative 2D showings for some 3D movies?
Which makes me wonder, how do you make like 2D animation into 3D?
Yeah, like, I mean, like, you know, remember when Blu-ray was shown first time, and you know they were hyping up the Simpsons movie in Blu-ray? Almost like saying to myself, what's so special about this one? Because it's looked exactly like the one in the movie theater. And then when they tried to put the Simpsons in 3D, I'm like, okay, now it looks like it's, you know, paper cutout of cartoon characters getting out of the background.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. That's basically what they do whenever they re-release an older movie that wasn't originally in 3D in 3D.
Especially if it's like a really old one, like Lion King. Like, how do you 3D that movie?
I mean, it's the same thing. What they do is they basically put the movie in this program and it isolates all the different moving elements and then just layers them so that it looks like there's some depth there. But I would imagine, I haven't seen, because I'm so opposed to this idea of just re-releasing movies just for the sake of having them in 3D, that I haven't seen it. But I would imagine the effect is that it looks like a pop-up book, basically.
Yeah, it does. All right. Reason number 7, 3D glasses cause eye strains, headaches, and motion sickness.
Yeah, I think we've covered that one.
So does The Hunger Games. Well, motion sickness is kind of, everyone has their own resistance to it. Like, some people can handle roller coasters better than others, and car rides.
Yeah, but I think, like, an image on the screen is still... But, you know, one of the few good things that I think have come out in recent years is that actually, like, one of the... John Green of the Vlog Brothers... Like, he actually developed because his wife was so, also got motion sickness from watching 3D movies, that he actually went out and called to a company and had them make 2D glasses that basically just focused the 3D image into a 2D image. So, he kind of fixed that. I know they were selling them at one point, but
they have 2D glasses?
I gotta send you the video at some point, but you could at least one point you could mail order those, but I don't know if they have them anymore. But that was an actual thing that they did. He called up a manufacturer of 3D glasses, and they basically just made the polarization so that a 3D image would become a 2D image. And now Hank Green's wife can now watch 3D movies without getting motion sickness, basically.
Cindy, it's your turn.
My turn. Reason number 8. Thank you. Pointless re-releases of films. We've talked about this a lot already.
Yeah, we had it, yeah.
Okay, reason number 9. Some movies are made explicitly to exploit the 3D trend.
Like I said before, two words, Piranha 3D.
Man, I also hate it when movies are entitled 3D. Like almost every Nintendo 64 game is entitled N64. I mean, come on.
Yeah.
Somebody wrote into Nintendo Power about that. They were saying, why do that? It's kind of a pointless gimmick. They replied saying, so you're not in favor of us renaming the magazine's Nintendo Power 64? Like, that was kind of mean. That was kind of rude.
We're getting off topic, but the 64 trend is like, they did actually, like, in later years, they kind of tried to avoid that. Like, some games have the 64 title in their Japanese releases, but then they went out of their way to give them completely different English names to avoid that. And even still, we ended up, like, three games with the title Bomberman 64. So
Bomberman Hero, Bomberman 64.
I made a blog about that, but Bomberman Heroes... is called, I think, Bomberman 64 2 in Japan, because... No, wait, that's Bomberman 64, and the Bomberman 64 that we have is Bomberman 64 2
Wouldn't that be 642?
No, 64 2, like Final Fantasy 13 2.
Oh my god.
Yeah, the same kind of stupid crap.
Or 10-2.
10-2.
Ah, that game was... horrible. Yeah. They changed the victory music. That's just a sin.
All right, now. Okay, now, finishing off this list.
I got one more. No, yeah. Reason number 10, not to be confused with number 9. It's just a fad, and we all know it. You know it, we all know it.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Like that's the big thing, is, like, everybody seems to kind of get that, okay, this is just a thing that people are now doing. The thing is that I'm just so... pissed off about it. I just can't wait for it to go away, honestly. Like,
finally get some writers and new directors. Yeah, big it's a big statement. New directors to actually make good film. Better films than what we get from the last couple of decades. I mean, like, good God almighty.
You mean like me? I am in film school, you know.
Yeah, I can't wait to see your film one of these days.
It'll be about platypuses and how we can save them.
I got one question. If you become a director, would you make your film into 3D?
No. I would not have the budget to do that because I will never go to Hollywood.
Okay.
I didn't hear anything that was.
I hated when the 3D falls on the third installment, because then they make a big deal out of it. Oh, it's Men in Black 3D or something like that. Oh. No. Why the third one? Why does it have to be the third one? Well, it was Duke Nukem 3D, but that was back when 3D meant something else.
Because Men in Black 2D will not sell anything extra.
I kind of liked Men in Black 2, but I think that they could have cut the final scene out of the movie. It would have still been good.
It was kind of weird that they snuck Michael Jackson in there. I can be Agent M.
I love that.
Oh, yeah, that was great.
I mean, Michael Jackson, the person, not so much, but whenever he's in a movie, like, that's okay with me.
Well, that's the list. Have you remembered what you want to say yet?
I haven't a clue.
I mean, like, that's the whole purpose of going over your list was to give you some time to remember what you wanted to say about 3D.
We've talked about so many things. We've even managed to cover Nintendo 64 somehow. I think we covered pretty effectively, unless you have something else to say and add to all of this.
I think it's about time we went to 4D.
Right.
Now we'll act.
The screen is now a portal and stuff literally flies at you.
Oh my goodness.
I think the 3D glasses should only exist to protect your eyes from the bright light.
So I guess we have everything that we want to rant about, you know, the stupid 3D technology. So what are your final statements, you guys, about 3D technology before we close this episode of Rants on the Run?
I give it 2 more years at best.
I have to say that either the technology needs to get a lot better, a lot less embarrassing for everybody, and, you know, just generally less in your face, or otherwise I cannot wait for it to just go away.
All right, here's my final statement. Hollywood, you guys have been using 3D technology for way before, you know, around the time when my grandfather was in diapers, and you still cause people with headaches and all that kind of shit, just for the amusement of making gimmick a little more exciting and a lot more amusing to go to the movie theaters. But for crying out loud, can you finally just stop making movies, you know, better by graphically, and instead just make your movies better by screenplay, cinematography, and innovation, for crying out loud? Because to me, the more you guys are trying to make your, you know, picture a lot more brighter and a lot more amusing, the much less quality we're getting in our films nowadays, because, for crying out loud.
Well, it's one of those times where you must rant and run away from feedback. I am Mr. Sendo, and I do not approve this uncle.
And I'm Gexup, and I like to say fuck 3D.
And I'm Hanu the Honda Makinen, and I'm going to say stay safe out there.
For more of Hanu's written reviews, check his drop-down menu and click written movie or written game reviews. It'll link you to his written blog. Bye-bye!